Okay, we'll call the meeting of the Conway Board of Selectmen to order at 6:00 PM on Monday, April 3rd. First item on the agenda is minutes of the March 28th, 2017 meeting. I have a motion to approve the minutes.
I approved them, they look good to me.
Were you second?
I'd second it too.
Okay, and we all, okay. The motion has been approved on this matter and we'll approve it. One vendor warrants, we have a vendor warrant 17-21 for $17,180. A student activity account warrant 17-21A for $2,642. Payroll warrant for 17-21 for $99,541. And a payroll deduction warrant 17-21 for a $25,850 amount. You have a motion to approve these warrants?
I would move that.
Okay.
And I'd second it.
All in favor?
Second my own motion?
No.
I can't second my own motion.
You're the same person.
Oh, so you have to second it.
I'll second, okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Just wanted to make sure.
You're the first person.
Okay, meetings attended by the selectmen. See, last Wednesday, we, the three of us met with the...
Sorry about that.
That was the EverSource meeting down in Hadley. It was a very good meeting with them. They explained a lot about electrical safety and showed us their high voltage trailer to try to teach everybody to stay away from the high voltage lines running down and stuff like that. It was very, very interesting, I thought. And we had a good discussion and John talked and I talked a little bit about our tornado we had in Conway and everything worked out good that night.
It was a great night. I don't know if you'd seen that demo before, but it was...
And Tom was there too.
It was quite amazing, yeah. Watch him cook a hot dog.
Ron was there with us too.
A hot dog and a bolt of lightning, so...
Any other meetings you attended?
So I went to a FERCog meeting the next night on Thursday night. FERCog did a, an hour, hour and a half presentation about climate change and a bunch of people from Conway were there. Joe Strugowski was there. And Tom was there. And it was educational, it was good. I can't say there was anything that you might not have already known, but if you aren't following what's going on, it was good.
And it was the FERCog's response to, it was planning for climate change. So flood, you know, looking at flood basins and things like that.
A lot of the work came out of Hurricane Irene, looking at how to look at maps and predict, you know, on which side of a river there will be a lot of erosion and which side is more, is safer and what to do about hillsides and how to look at topo maps and see what's gonna happen.
Okay.
Excellent.
Okay, next item is citizens' concerns. Do we have any citizen concerns tonight? Anybody know of? Seeing none, I guess we'll move on to the next one. Old business. Do we want to jump around a little bit, Tom, and have you do your budget, town meeting warrant stuff at the end or not?
Yeah, well, it's all under this. The first thing to cover is the highway hydraulic lift and salaries and wages. The background is that there was some discussion of this, both these items last week. And Ron wasn't there to explain and Dana, representing the Capital Improvements Planning Committee, had gone over this previously with the committee and we just thought we'd, because there were questions, we thought we'd get as much settled now as we can, you know, before moving forward. So,
Come on, Ron.
Just give background of what the Capital Improvements Planning Committee did and then Ron can fill in anything or...
Why doesn't Ron tell you why he wants it? Because why he wants it was based on...
Right. But I will note that it was recommended by the Capital Improvements.
It was recommended by the Capital Improvement Committee, which a select board member is a member of that committee and a member of the Finance Committee is a member. And when you brought up the issue of liability, it was one of the things that we discussed and I'm a little surprised that neither one of the members spoke to that.
Well, it was something we'd never talked about when we had our meeting, and I wish...
Oh, we did.
Well, not that I remember. Okay, so I was wishing you were there, so you could
talk. So that's my point. I mean, if you're going to be bringing these things up and voting on things, and nobody's there to...
defend them, I guess. If that's
I mean, I feel like it's why do you meet with the committee if it's not, you know, there's no support from the committee members? The issue with liability, that isn't any different, as I explained. Actually, it's a better thing for the town to be able to have this lift in the way we do things now with tree trimming and, you know, hangers, trees that are hanging over the roadway, instead of standing in the back of a dump truck with a pole saw.
I agree.
This thing is going to eliminate all these.
Can you explain to us what actually looks like or what it is, Ron?
It's just it's powered by itself. You can drive it, move it down the road. It's got a 6 or 8 foot basket on it, so two men can be in the basket. There's some that are 500 pound capacity, some up to 1,000. So being able to be where the branches are, you know, when you're cutting and letting them fall down so that you're not under it. That's a huge problem that we have with pole saws, is you cut and you're coming it from underneath. You're in the danger zone. The other thing is all the other benefits that the town could have with this, like buildings. And you made the comment that highway guys aren't going to do things.
Right, which they wouldn't normally.
No, it's part of their job description. Is outside building maintenance is part of the highway department's, at least in the new job descriptions. The other thing is you're saying...
It's in your job description, no. Not an employee's job description.
Well, yes, it is.
Beg to differ that one. But maybe I'm wrong. I could be wrong.
Well, look, it should be if it's...
I just want that
under the superintendent
building. The other thing is you made the comment that with the parking lot out back that the highway department should just go and do it. Well, you just contradicted yourself in what the highway department does.
Well, except we now agree that it's in the highway department job descriptions to work on town buildings.
Correct.
So.
Okay. Well, it's just that he did say that the parking lot should be paid for out of the highway budget.
Right. I just would have, you know, like, I used to touch it up a few times when I was highway superintendent. We just took the materials that we normally use on the roads or hard pack or gravel we were going to use. We just did it a little bit. That was my statement. That about that.
Okay. Because the whole point of what happened there is that started out as a paving job.
Yeah, it's just
that got reduced down to
just
doing the hard pack because of the leach field and stuff like that.
But you had to buy some stuff for that.
Yeah, the material, because we got to tear out all the old oil and stone that's out back there. Right. I mean, it's not a 5-minute project. It's a 3 or 4 day project to do what we need to do out there. The point was that what Tom was trying to do was you have some money so that it can get fixed.
But your $3,000 was a lot less than what Tom was asking for.
Of course. Ron's going to do a lot more cheaper.
And that was, you know, that was through the process of working
with
the capital improvements planning.
As far as the lift, the safety part of it, as far as people operating it, it's a hoister's license that's required for it. They'll also be training for it, so...
You intend on getting them trained?
Well, of course. I mean, you can't just tell them to go out and use the thing and end up having them on their side.
You have the place you think they'll be willing to go up in?
Yes. Actually, that's one of the things that we've discussed, and everybody seems to think that they would rather be doing that than standing there with a pole saw. And then the other thing is there's a lot of stuff that we can't do with a pole saw.
Well, if anybody's ever tried to use a pole saw, once you get very far over your head, you get halfway through the limb and it's going to bind on the saw.
Well, we've done a lot of tree trimming.
Have you considered a possibly used bucket truck compared to that, or is it way overpriced?
No, the bucket truck was a thought, but
it's
this thing actually is more beneficial because you can have two people in at the where you're working. So if, like telephone wires, you know what they're like when there's a tree on a telephone wire, that they're spring loaded.
Yes, they are.
Way better off being close to the wire, you know, so they trim it back to take the weight instead of trying to do it from the ground. As far as hiring out, I know it's a very expensive thing to have tree companies come in and...
I'm sure it is.
And then when you have an emergency, I mean, trying to get somebody to come in to do what you need done, I mean, if it's just a small tree, but it's where we can't reach it, it's very expensive to have them come in and do it.
It does seem like Verizon does not trim trees anymore.
They never have, as far as I know. But.
Well, I think one of the things that Ron brought up that made a lot of sense was the utilities trim one side of the road. Mm-hmm. They're not going to trim both sides. And there's a lot of offsides that they can do that would preclude trees coming down in storms. So, Well, if you drive around town, you can see there's definitely where the power lines, the utilities, it's trimmed back on the other side of the road. It's
up on the Shelburne Falls Road, north of where I am, there's no power lines on those poles.
Nope.
And so nobody trims them.
Speaking in that area, that's where you got all the small trees that are hanging over the road, but they're so far back on out of the right of way that we can't go cut them at the bottom.
Is there any other towns that use a piece of equipment like this, Ron?
I know there's towns that are using bucket trucks, but I don't know, my experience, I've used these boom lifts before, and they're so much more versatile because when you can actually move the machine while you're not way up in the air, but there's a certain height that it still moves. So it gets you into where...
So it doesn't have stabilizers on it?
No.
And you can control it from the basket?
Yes. You can control it from... Yeah.
Can you control it from the ground too?
Yes.
When we talked to them about bucket truck versus the man lift, you get a lot more bang for your buck on a man lift. When you start talking about used bucket trucks, now you're talking about a used truck with a hoist on it. So
what is a bucket? Is that a bucket truck what the utilities use?
Yes.
Yes. So once you're in the bucket, you can't move the truck. Mm-hmm. So whatever, if you're 5 feet short of where you want to be, you got to go all the way back down.
Well, I do think, and I'll state this to the day I die, that you are increasing your liability of employees by using it.
I disagree.
Because you're up in the air.
I disagree greatly over that because I think we're increasing our safety because being able to not be underneath the material that you're cutting down.
Well, you're going to be cutting a lot more stuff with this than you are with on the ground feet, too.
That's also the intent.
My biggest concerns there was, what if you cut a limb that started to come over and it got within the striking distance of the power line on the other side, not to strike the line itself, but as we all know, you don't have to touch the line to get them to jump, electricity to jump. Just be within that jumping range.
But this gives you the opportunity to cut a shorter branch because you're able to reach it instead of trying to cut a full length branch at your, in my opinion, this would make our operations a lot safer for the guys.
Felt that, as far as overall safety, that I felt that should be left up to professionals. That's just me. That's my way of thinking.
So where do you determine that we're not professionals?
No, I'm not saying that.
No, I'm
but
asking
the guys that do it every day of the week are more professional at it than you guys would be.
Well, you are going to get training, right?
Yeah, and I don't understand that comment.
Why?
Because
you can't tell me that a guy that runs a bucket loader his whole life, 8 hours a day, isn't probably going to be a better operator than a guy who only uses it once in a while.
Depends on the person.
Well, it's true.
So, it's all kind of irrelevant to what you're...
You can argue with me, I don't.
Yeah, yeah.
That's your problem.
I'm not looking to argue, I'm just trying to state a fact. I mean, I'm very disappointed in the way this whole thing has worked, because you go through the process that you're working on, and then I'm back here now because the process hasn't worked.
Well, we can talk about this conversation at town meeting.
Yes, and that's the whole point, but I'm not, yeah. I'm very unhappy that both the select board and now the finance committee is not recommending it.
Right.
I don't think that's fair, because a select board member and a finance committee member was on the committee, is on the committee, and...
Was anybody there from the finance committee the night we talked about
yes,
that?
Yes, Roy Cohen.
Roy was, yeah.
He was.
And
yeah.
he was at the meeting last week.
Yeah.
And it's very...
Well, I don't remember us having a conversation.
Well, you can run into them things because of the way that we set things up here. Is we have the people come in to do the discussions in different departments, and we wait to a later date to vote on it.
Well, I would appreciate then if there's an item that's on the thing that I'm asked to be there so that I can defend, because is it going to get voted on again?
Well, now? We voted last week.
No.
That's my point. So I'm at a huge disadvantage from the town's support end. And it's frustrating.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I went through the whole process the way it's supposed to work, and I ended up...
Well, you're going to find, Ron, you've been around enough, long enough like I have.
I understand that.
Your job can be very disappointing sometimes, because I bought up many proposals over a 20-year period and got shot full of holes.
I understand that, but that's some of what this process is supposed to help eliminate.
Hey?
I'm just making, you know...
Mm-hmm. Your statement.
How I'm
that's all right.
Statement.
I don't blame you. People should need to hear how you feel. Any more about on that?
Anything more on this?
It would be a good to talk about this in the pre-town meeting also. You know, I mean, I really think a lot of issues get resolved in the pre-town meeting a week or so before town meeting. And I don't mind putting in a plug for the pre-town meeting. People should come to that.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent.
I agree 100%.
Okay, everybody all set on that portion?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how about highway salaries and wages, Ron?
All right. Well, as you know...
Yeah.
I think
thanks, Danny.
Thank you.
I cannot open your notes.
I could come over to your house if you want to work on this, or...
I don't know.
We could talk...
Files and stuff that I opened. But.
Yeah, it's just a text file. It's not a Word file. If you're trying to open it with Word, it won't.
It should open.
But probably Word would should open it. Yes,
it comes as a file attached to an email. And when I click on it to open it, it won't open.
I sent it to you. Were you able to open it?
Which file was this?
The minutes.
My minutes. The minutes to that meeting.
I think I was.
I didn't have
any fun.
Where was that?
He may not have a program to open it. He may have, because I know that there's certain programs, like my home computer, I can't open things because I don't have a certain program to open.
It's just a basic, I mean, I intentionally write these things as a text file because everybody can open a text file.
So
I don't even use Word.
I hope that the two of you can
work on it. Sure.
Thank you, Dan.
A couple of tin cans and some strings.
Here I go.
Better. Appreciate it, Dana. Thank you.
Nice. Thank you. Thank good night.
All right. Salaries. Now, I'm not... I know when I met with the select board before, I went over this whole thing as my restructured,
Well, I had a couple of questions on just the dollar amounts, and I felt of one of them that you may have cut yourself a little shorter than you needed to be.
Yeah, and one of the reasons that was that we had not included the 2.5% raise in the calculation.
Mm-hmm.
We were doing an apples and oranges subtraction there,
mm-hmm.
so the number that we were talking about actually isn't a useful number to use.
I got a little confused as to what's in each category, too. You know what
yeah.
I mean? What's the line items in each category? Like your hourly, your salary, hourly wage scale for the highway department. Your budget 60,000 last year, you're asking for 61,503 this year.
That was a mistake. this year is 61, the one that's proposed for this year. That would,
okay.
That's what my salary is for this year.
Yeah,
that, the old figure, that's strictly just your salary?
Just my salary.
Did not include the 2.5%.
That didn't include anything else, okay.
From last year.
So the additional amount that you're putting in for a foreman's position is in the other wage one?
In the wages.
Okay, and that is your part-time secretary in there too?
Yes, yes. She's okay. In there too.
And that's part of that $8,024 increase? All in.
Yes, the two truck drivers, laborer positions, that's $83,283 and, $283. The foreman position is $43,722, and these are current wages, well, not including the 2.5, so okay. That's, I'm guessing that's some of the problem why things were coming up.
Could be, yeah.
Yeah, the current figures are much higher. They also include the clerk
well,
going
see, the
from
paper we get doesn't show how you
hours.
Categorize things here on this one. The one we were just endorsed a couple weeks ago.
What's that?
It doesn't show how you categorize that one.
Because it's all under... Oh. No, I don't
it's
know.
It's just salaries and hourly wages is all it is. No, they're all combined. So.
Yeah, we can get you more detailed breakdown.
I was just concerned, you know, somehow I was afraid you weren't gonna come up enough money to. I know if you talked about $1 an hour for whatever the foreman's going to be,
mm-hmm.
And that figures out $2,080 a year, and I thought it was only at $1,165. Why are you going to be short $900?
And one of the other items was the raise to $16 for the laborer.
Right.
That was not, it turns out, a raise from $12. It was a raise from 2.5% over $12. So okay.
So that's figured into the 16.
Those are a
too?
Couple of things. Yes. And okay. The I think the your clerk's going from 5 to 8 hours or 6 to 8 hours.
She's,
something yes. like that. So we've gone through that extensively since then.
She seemed very pleasant. Seems like
we
you do a really good job, huh?
Correct
and
figures.
And I actually
now.
Wish I had discussed it with Tom earlier about her a pay increase for what she's doing. Because she's working, she does things at amazingly
well,
fast
pace. She'll get the 2.5 hour, right?
Yeah,
she's very good.
She can open email with Ashman.
Okay.
Yes.
What else was there?
So that's
is that all we had for Ron? I guess we're
all right. Yeah, we did solve those problems, those questions. Yeah.
How are you coming on the replacement?
Hopefully we'll have somebody in next Monday.
Have you done any interviewing?
We've interviewed and have a second interview tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And hopefully
looks good.
Yeah,
good.
It's real good.
Good. Great. Bob, do you have any questions?
No, it's good.
Ron, you got one more question for us?
No, please, sir.
Great. Well, thank you.
I'm sorry you have to come in again. Appreciate that.
All right. Tom, budget and town meeting warrant articles. Tom?
Yeah, this is almost a final version of the warrant. If you look, skip down to the bottom line. We're going up almost the same amount total that we went up last year.
Is this your newest copy here, Tom?
Yeah. It's almost the same amount. It's actually $3,003 less than last year, but pretty darn close. Of course, since we're starting from a higher number, it's a 5.22% increase rather than last year's 5.57%. So as a percentage increase, it's going down more. I'm still looking into this separating out the town and grammar school employee costs. There are various budgeting mechanisms that Jan uses that may make that not the best thing to put on the warrant itself, which becomes a binding document. For example, she often includes some money in case somebody bumps up their health insurance program, for example, or
and it could be either the town or
or we get mm-hmm. And we don't know that, and that would take that flexibility mm-hmm. away, and we might actually end up budgeting more money to take care of those contingencies if we had to do it both on the town and yeah. the yeah. school side. It's worked out so far the way she's done it. So she'll be talking more with John, who's not able to be here tonight, mm-hmm. about that. But this is the way I have it set up now, in a different font, italicized, and offset, so that people don't think that it's...
All the percentage raises for... You know... Wages have already been added into everything?
Well, this is just under employee costs.
Oh, okay.
So that's... it's health benefits mostly, and retiree benefits. Let's see. I believe that all the other articles are in their proper form, with one exception of some changes that may happen to some of the planning board articles. Town council reviewed them, mm-hmm. and the planning board is holding a hearing, I believe, Wednesday evening to propose those changes, because they have to have a hearing on that, and depending on the results of that, I'll get the final wording for the planning articles. So aside from the planning articles, this should be the final version. So please look at it with eagle eyes and let me know if there's anything that needs to be changed. I can see one right now. I have an extra Capital Improvements Planning Committee recommendation, which has to do with the Conway Grammar School capital account, which...
Which number is that? Huh?
Which shouldn't be in there. Seven. Under Article 7. Yeah. There's a space for a recommendation from the Capital Improvements Planning Committee, and there really shouldn't be, so I'll take that out. So I'm hoping that they're mostly items like that that aren't substantive, mm-hmm. but... the more eyes that look at this, the better. It's a very complicated process, as you know. So any help is more than welcome. I do have the vote for the ambulance bill from the previous fiscal year. Mike?
Can they get those figures all set to you, the ambulance figures?
Yes.
Okay. Thirsty.
So yeah. what article was that?
That's Article 16.
So I see 13 and 16, right.
Yes, and we've taken out the...
Should they be together?
Well, the way that I have this arranged is in descending order of money.
Okay, I see. Right.
And it's a really, that's a different kind of thing. I do put some things together that are linked without it having
right.
without it being, but that's together with the other bill from a previous fiscal year.
Uh-huh,
so
yeah.
So it's linked in that sense. We've taken the wastewater out of community preservation under Article 18. It remains as Article 3.
Yeah.
And everything has its recommendation numbers in it. A whole lot of planning stuff in here.
Yeah, there's a ton of planning stuff.
So, you know, ends up with three planning articles and two resolutions.
Yeah.
One other change that will happen is that we will have a section at the very end under the seal where it talks about adjourning the meeting until the election.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And the election will also have a ballot vote for the waste. Oh, it
may or may not.
It has to be posted
as it will, right?
But yes, and
then if it fails, it just don't get voted on.
Because it depends upon we'll
put it on.
I think you have to list it on.
But I'm not sure whether it's at the town election, or it may have to be like 30 days away or something. It may have to be a separate election. So I have a note to check that with Jimmy.
Right, yeah.
So I'm not sure.
I know in the past, most anything that's two-thirds vote on town meeting floor has to have a second vote. It's usually that following Thursday.
Hmm. Oh, it certainly has to have a second vote, and that's actually in the article itself. It says contingent on the passage of a Proposition 2.5 debt exclusion ballot question.
Right.
So the question is, when does that ballot question happen? Does it happen at the town election or afterwards? So I will check with the town clerk on that.
Right.
So again, just please look at, carefully at all of this.
Okay.
And there will be some changes to the planning, one or more of the planning board articles. Okay. And I think all of the dates are correct, times. Just innumerable details here. Mm-hmm. So I think we're going to be good to go in a week. And that's good. And Lisa is finishing up the town report now. And I have in my budget, I had an explanation of the changes in Article 2 that I want to attach to the front of the warrant just as an explanation. So when they look at it, they'll say, wait a minute, this doesn't look the same way it usually does.
So, how you reformatted it.
Yeah. Okay. So there's an explanation that I'm just copying, and I want to put that on
That's
the front.
That's a good idea. Should cut down a lot of the questions.
Just to let people know. And the wastewater committee will have a separate information piece that we're planning also to send out with the warrant as an insert into the town report. So they have an information piece as well. And you also mentioned the pre-town meeting. I have something about that in my report later. So I think that's...
Do we have anything under other business?
I will also be working on the motions for these that will identify all the sources of funding as planned.
Okay.
So that's about it.
Okay. Next item is new business. Sign of notification of intent to harvest timber on land abutting town land. Mr. Hill, come on over.
All right. As promised, some better maps of the parcel that we're talking about.
Oh, great. That's better than this one. Good.
Tell them how you made this, too.
I actually made that with the Access GIS software that the town assessors use.
Oh,
it's
nice.
Online.
Nice.
So anyone can make something like this.
Huh.
So the
These lines are accurate as opposed to
they are the other black picture. Lines actually follow the tax parcel overlay. The red line is an approximation of the actual harvest area. We're not going all the way to the property line or going across the entire parcel. We are going fairly close to the property line with the dump, but all pins have been found and remarked, so there will be no crossing of lines.
Is that little white spot up there?
Nope. The dump is the oval out of the center.
Oh yeah.
Kind of cuts out of it.
Okay, I'm looking at this wrong. Yeah.
So the two black dots, those are proposed landing sites.
I had upside down. Sorry.
Where the logs will be pulled out to and then loaded onto trucks.
Mm-hmm.
The letter of intent is required by, I believe it's chapter 132. Forestry law requires all butters to be notified. Normally, it's a certified letter that gets sent out, 10-day waiting period before you can start work. I'm trying to adjudicate the 10 days, so by getting the letter signed by the butters, I can thereby prove that there's no objection mm-hmm. to the harvest. And that's the purpose. It's just to
so
get
you would like us to, if we approve this, to sign this tonight for you to get the ball rolling?
Yep. That way I can, you know, it's the last letter. The other two abutters have already been notified and signed their copies. And that way I can get the logger in as soon as he's able to get the machinery down.
Okay. I'll make a motion that we sign the official notification from the abutter about the logging going on the Hell property, Marjorie Hell landowner property. Do you have a second on that, Bob?
Second.
Any discussions?
I don't see anything wrong with it.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, Nick, I'll sign it. And
there are two original copies in the...
So this tourist, you know, you need to sign this night, right?
Right. Two is good. It's a majority.
Will we notice a difference from the dump at all?
Yes.
It'll be a little more open out into the woods?
It will be to the just off of the left-hand side of the platform. There will be a few pines that are coming out that will make a big change in the canopy. That's the intent of this harvest is actually to promote the sugar trees to grow better. So most of the softwoods are going to be removed.
So do you get these?
The one signed copy, and the other copy is
ours, right?
Just for your records.
Great.
That way it's all
set ready to go. I'm glad to see it's going to get picked up. That's a good idea.
That's
you
a whole
you got the right
story.
Idea of getting it all cleaned up where there's some value towards.
Well, this is this plan was actually signed and approved before the tornado hit. Cool. So this is stuff that was planned on being done beforehand. The cleanup effort, that is another set of cutting plans that was filed last week. So, just a waiting game on the state at this point. Mm-hmm. Right. So, you guys have no further questions? I'll stop.
Appreciate it, Nick.
Great.
Thanks for coming in and mentioning it to us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Yep. All right. Okay, next item on the agenda is any items not anticipated 48 hours in advance of the meeting. Do we have anything, Tom?
No.
Nothing there, okay. How about a town administrator update?
We have received word that our Chapter 90 money will be $265,608 in fiscal year 18. This is down slightly from this year's $268,147.
That's just so they didn't approve enough money to cover the last year's balance, right?
Well, the state is having some trouble. You know, the Mass Municipal Association always asks for funding of $300 million, mm-hmm. which is slightly under half of what's needed. And we usually get slightly under a third of what's needed. So,
is this what we were expecting, or were you expecting it level funded?
It's close, you know. It's a little disappointing that it's going down a little bit instead of up a little bit, but that's been the trend. So, the pre-town meeting organizers are proposing two possible dates for their annual event. I think you got the email from Mary.
Yep, we did.
May 1st and May 3rd. There is a select board meeting May 1st, and we usually have that prior to the event, which is scheduled for 7 to 8:30 p.m. So if you've, I encourage you to respond individually, or I can respond for you if you have a preference.
I think the first is fine. We had a pass like that.
There must be an issue with the first to have her be considering the third.
Well, she may be thinking that you're still meeting at 7.
Right.
So
we must meet at 6. It really isn't a plus.
Six. Yeah. 6 is perfect for that.
Says it's going out for two different nights.
While the select board and I were meeting with Eversource regarding their emergency management planning, There were about 45 Conway residents attending a meeting regarding federal aid for tornado cleanup for woodlands. The USDA has accepted the local Farm Service Agency's application for assistance, which means that FSA can start accepting applications. When requests for assistance have been totaled, a dollar value will be forwarded to Washington for approval. Mm. At that point, the Washington office can accept, deny, or modify, by prorating, the funding requested. FSA may start accepting applications as early as today. Landowners are encouraged to apply. The funding is good, and this is a one-time offer. I believe there is a one-month application period.
So this is the funding that got talked about at the grammar school fundraiser.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've been given a budget estimate for the Smith Vocational and Agricultural High School, though they have not yet presented final figures. Huh. It is a constant or an annual frustration to me that the school budgets come out so late. It makes it very difficult to put together a budget for the town, let alone, the warrant for the town, let alone an earlier budget.
Do you think in future times we should maybe consider moving the town meeting up a little bit, moving it further down the road a little bit to give it more time for these figures to get...
We're the last now.
No, we're the first, aren't we?
It's true.
No, we've moved it to be much later.
It's a common problem, and we are the last of the four frontier towns. This all depends on state decisions. A lot of the decisions about state technical school tuition are made by the state. Yeah. So it's not something that we really have any control over.
So what happens if we don't pass enough money?
You know, doing it later has its problems as well. We have a special town meeting where we move things from. It's not going to be that far off, and I believe that we're good. I've budgeted conservatively for it, but it's just a little unsettling not to have final figures when we're going to our own town meeting. But the superintendent and chair of the board of trustees will be in next week to discuss their school. This comes amid a climate of concern regarding mandated transportation costs to out-of-district schools when the local school does not offer a similar program. There is a review of technical school funding going on at the state level as well. There was a bill filed to remove this restriction, and it was tabled pending the whole system review that was going on at the time. But there's quite a movement at the state level to address this particular expense at the state level. I am working with Roy Cohen and Julie Petty to produce an online registration system for Conway Youth Sports. We intend to get that up and running for this season. In related news, I'm working with Roy to produce an updated website with more functionality and a more usable mobile version. Funding for this comes from a town meeting warrant article of several years ago. So that is the thing. Those are some things that I've been working for that aren't the warrant or the budget or all of these other things.
Today's Monday, and Ken's usually here, isn't he?
He's not upstairs?
No.
And maybe he's out on a call or something. I don't know.
If you hang on for just a couple of minutes, I'll get in touch with him and see if he can come in.
It's not really that important. It's not a police issue.
Oh.
Oh, okay. Well.
But I may be able to catch up with him, or my phone messages, I don't know if they're going to the right place. And,
yeah, they should be.
I'll wait out here for a few minutes.
All right, yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Sure. So, that's all I have for that.
Great. Next item is concerns of the selectmen. We got any concerns, Bob?
No.
Not hearing any. We move on. And mail, I guess we got no mail. Yeah. I know.
Is there nothing in the purple folder?
I don't see a purple folder.
Oh. Don't know if they're is or not, actually.
There is nothing in the purple folder.
Good.
The only thing that's in here are the beacons.
The what?
Oh, you got your beacons.
Oh,
oh
yes.
Yeah, hand okay. Hand, yeah, you can handle.
Yeah, we can
beacons.
Take them home.
Yeah. Yes, and our distinguished chair is in one of the photographs.
Oh, nice.
From that meeting in Greenfield.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He was sitting next, close to Senator Rosenberg.
Mm-hmm. Hey, good. Any announcements?
Hearing
no announcements. Our next meeting is scheduled for Monday, April 10th. Here in the town office building at 6 p.m. Hearing no other items for this meeting, I make a motion that we adjourn.
I second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.